welcome to Unique's 6th Children's Workshop. Today we are going to be making our own pirate or just boat scenes, depending on what you want. So while we're doing boats and things today, you could also do it with your own house or anything you want. We have a lot of different materials for this workshop. The first thing you need is your paper, and you'll need some cardboard as well. So I'm going to cut out this box. Basically what we're going to do is we're going to paint on the paper, or use markers, or whatever you want. And you're gonna do, say, the sea here, and the sky up here. And then, using your card, you're gonna draw on the card, and you're gonna draw a pirate ship. And you're gonna cut that out, and you're gonna stick that on your paper. So it'll be kind of 3D, it'll be really fun. So you'll also need some toilet roll tubes. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna cut these in half, we're gonna paint it, and the toilet roll tubes are going to become the seals on the pirate ship. Then the other things I have here are a selection of different paints, pencils to draw, some markers, and paintbrushes. And I also have some glue and my scissors. So you'll probably need an adult to help you with this, especially if you're using scissors, so make sure to ask. Okay, so let's get started. One of the good things about this workshop is that you don't have to be very good at drawing for it. I'm not very good at drawing, so this is really fun. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cut out my box so I can get started on the shape of the boat. Okay. So you don't have to use a cardboard box for this. You can use a cereal box or any other cardboard you have in your house. So now I have cut my cardboard out. So what I'm going to do next is start drawing the shape of the boat on it in pencil. So I'm going to go over here. It doesn't have to be a very good drawing. It doesn't have to be a very big boat either. So it can just be any kind of shape. So this is the general shape of the boat. And I'm going to take my black marker and go over the shape that I want. So just again, it doesn't have to be perfect. I'm gonna paint over this anyway. So, now we have the base of our boat. We're just gonna cut it out. Finished cutting out my boat. So I'm going to put this aside now and I'm going to start colouring in my scenes. This paper is just regular A4 printer paper, but it's not big enough for the size of my boat. And if I turn it this way, I still don't have as much room as I would like. So instead of getting bigger paper, we can just take two sheets of regular paper and put them together. Like this. So you can stick them together with either glue or sellotape. I'm just going to use my glue stick. All you do is go down in one line where you're going to stick the page. That's fine. Okay, so now we have a much bigger page, which means our boat can go here. We can have a beautiful scene all around it. So, I'm gonna start creating my scene. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have big swirly waves. And your waves can be any size or shape you want. So I've just drawn my waves. And I'm gonna start painting. Thank you. Before, when I was doing the base color, I was just going in straight lines. Now I'm trying to make the shapes of waves in my paint. So take up and then down and back up a little bit. So like these lines, I'm doing it over and over again. It just means it looks a bit more natural. So, I'm going to leave this over here to dry, and I'm going to start decorating my ship. Some circles for the windows. And I'm just going to draw as many details as you want on this, or as few details as you want. Okay, now I'm just going to do a little bit of the yellowy color up here. Now this is dry. So now we just need to wait for our pirate ship to dry, and we can get on putting them together. What we can do in the meantime is take our toilet roll, and we can start making our masts. So all you want to do is cut a straight line. And go to the opposite side. And cut another straight line. So you're just cutting this in half, okay? It doesn't have to be even, it doesn't have to be perfect, it's fine either way. And these are gonna be our seals. So these can be any color you want. I'm gonna choose my color now. And I'm gonna start painting. Make sure you have a tablecloth or something underneath. I'm gonna use this paper. Protect my table. we have our ship, and we have our seals, and then we need the mast for it. So again, leave these all to dry. I'm going to take some of my leftover cardboard, and I'm just going to cut out a straight line, another straight line, and you're going to do this for three different ones, okay? And then we're going to do one much bigger one, much taller. Perfect. Put the cardboard away. Now we just need to paint these. I'm going to paint these brown, the same color that I painted my ship. So now we just leave everything to dry for a little bit. But while we leave those to dry, we can go back to this. So, we need to glue down our pirate ship. So you can glue it down wherever you want. I'm going to glue mine here. So I take my glue stick. You can also use sticky tape instead if you'd like. And I'm going to put glue all on the back. All the back of it. I'm just going to stick it down. Just roughly in the middle. It doesn't have to be perfect. Then the next thing we're going to do is take one of our small masts. Okay? So we're going to do the same here. We're going to take our glue and put our glue all on the back of this. Stick it down. Take our other one. Glue all on the back, and then we're going to stick it down. Perfect. And we just have one more. This is our big tall one. So it's obviously much too big, so we're going to cut it down a bit. Still a bit too big. You know, just a little bit off. There we go, that's much better. Okay, so again, just take your glue. Put it along the back. You don't need to get all of it, but the more glue you get on the back of it, the more likely it is to stay stuck down. The next thing we're going to do is take our seals. These are obviously a bit too big, so I'm going to do is cut them in half. Much better. Now this is going to need cut as well, but I'm not going to cut it as small. Instead of cutting it in half, I'm cutting it here. So we're going to have them like this. Okay, so we can't glue these down. So we're going to use some sellotape instead. So I'm cutting off about this much sellotape. And then I'm going to take it, wrap it around, and we have our own double-sided tape. We're going to do the same thing here. Now, when you're using your double-sided sellotape, something that really helps is the way you put it down. Here is our pirate ship. So, let's see if this is it. Now we have made our own pirate ship scene. So you can do all of this with paints or markers or anything you want. You can use cereal boxes, you could use tissue paper, you could use leaves from outside and paint on them. You're not limited to just cardboard and paint. It's anything you want. The more original, the better. The more creative, the better. So once you've made it, try to take a photo and send it into our Facebook page or our Instagram and we can upload it. We'd love to see them. Thank you so much for taking part in this workshop. We will have another post-it next Saturday at 2 p.m.